guys for sticking around this long. I'm gonna start again properly. You all know what alpacas are. I think I showed you the picture a little earlier. They are, in a way, fluffy llamas, but they're not llamas. They are the smaller, much nicer version, not rude like their cousins, the llamas. And they are known for having a lot of fluffy wool. And you will see, if you just do a quick Google image search, you will see alpacas with all sorts and shapes and colors of fur that is just really quite a colorful sight to look at. And furthermore, alpacas are known for shearing their fur. So when they do shear their fur, they have very ridiculously looking shapes. And they sell the fur and whatnot. And all in all, these animals are just really fun, really fluffy, really worth having on a farm. And I'm not saying you buy a farm. My job for you guys today is to look and see if you can possibly invest in an alpaca at some point. I think I did that good. Okay, alpacas first off are not really that difficult as we would imagine a llama to be. A llama provides many misconceptions, but this ain't a llama. Alpacas are very easy to handle. You can lead them all over the farm or whatnot. They are generally indifferent to humans if brought up properly, so that if you were to let a little kid go and hug the alpaca wouldn't react. It would just be like, hug me all you want. You can do whatever you want. A llama, we know, would spit, do whatever, kick, much more dangerous things, right? Same thing with probably another variety of animals. They would just get really defensive or violent or whatever a typical animal reaction is, right? Alpacas are herd animals by nature, so you don't get one. You get at least three or more. But for now, let's just talk about one. They are very soft and fluffy, and as mentioned before, they have a ginormous amount of wool in them that grows year-long and that is sheared usually in the spring. And of course, this is one of the selling factors, one of the cute factors for everyone, that, oh my god, a fluffy alpaca. They are, how do I put it, they're very good in itself. They're very great animals to watch, great animals to have as pets, but you can't be around them all the time, right? As with any animal, if you stay around an animal too long, you'll over-socialize them and they'll start to need their space. So as long as you respect an alpaca space, they will just be fine. Now, of course, it's gonna, over-socializing danger is gonna bring the question up about, are they dangerous? Well, alpacas don't bite in the conventional sense in that they don't have jaws. They don't have proper jaws. So even if you were to stick your hand in there, your hand is gonna get wet. They won't really bite you. They wouldn't even bite you in the first place, really. And do alpacas spit? Well, yes, but at each other, not at you. At very rare, I guess, alpaca-alpaca altercations. But if you have an allergy to alpaca spit, don't worry. You're fine. You can own an alpaca. Moving on, alpacas are very sturdy, hardy animals. They survive where no other animals would survive, or rather, put it correctly, they survive longer and better than other animals would. Now, alpacas hail from South America, in the where they come from the Andes Mountains. And the Andes Mountains are really cold, really unforgiving, and alpacas are just one of those animals that live to tough out everything. So in a way where other animals, other pets would require all sorts of vet checkups and I don't know what other pets do. But an alpaca can just live through anything. I may be overgeneralizing it, but that's pretty much what it boils down to. Alpaca can live through a lot of things that pets wouldn't be able to do, right? They live to at least 15 years. Some live up to 20 years, so they do live a long time. They're not just something that they're gonna give up on you after like a couple years, you know? Of course, this means that over the long run, they do have less health risks, less danger to, they pose less of a danger to themselves. They won't develop problems. They're just a better, I guess, health, they're better health-wise than most other pets, right? And of course, that's gonna raise the issue of they're gonna live for 15, 20 years, how am I gonna take care of them, right? food, they eat grass. The grass outside this place is that same grass. They don't require anything special. They don't need any expensive food or special diets. It's as simple as it is grass. And I mean, if you're going to be very specific, give them a low protein diet, but it's nothing to really spend money on, right? Plus, the way they eat grass, they eat the top, they don't eat the roots underneath, so the grass can regrow itself after a little bit. So you don't even have to pay for the grass in the first place, you don't pay for it again if they eat it, and so on and so forth. It's pretty much like free food for the alpacas, right? Shelter, you give like a three-walled structure, like a mini house. You give it sprinklers on property so they can cool themselves off, because I mean, if they're wearing all that wool, they're gonna get hot at some point, right? You give them fences so they don't jump over it and run off and eat the grass elsewhere, because that would be a catastrophe. After all, they are pretty much living lawnmowers. And of course, this is gonna run the risk of, okay, I have pets. What's gonna happen? Is it gonna cost money? How's that gonna work? Good thing is you can make money off alpacas. And how does that work? You can sell their wool. Now, as I told you, they're very fluffy. They have a lot of wool. A lot of breeders have spring shearing season, where they go, they get all the, alpacas. They get all the alpacas together and they shear them. And they make, collect all the wool and they pretty much sell it, make it into fine clothing and whatever they do with fiber. It's a very, it's an industry that is in very high demand of alpaca fiber. And people make a lot of money off it. And of course the mathematics. Alpaca fiber, if you shear one alpaca, most likely they will produce about 90 ounces of first grade, first class alpaca fiber. And about 100 ounces of second, third class alpaca fiber. Together, that's like 190, almost 200, right? If you have about 190 ounces of alpaca fiber and you take it by like $5 per ounce, that's what the price is so far, you get about $950 per alpaca. But usually these are herd animals, right? So you have at least three. So multiplied by three, you have almost about $6,000. And that's not $6,000, about $3,000. Excuse my mouth. But if you find if you process the fibers, you make it a final product, you can double the price, 6,000. And the more alpacas you have, the more money you get, and it goes on and on. To conclude, alpacas are not do not fit the stereotype that their llama cousins present. They're nice mannered, they're somewhat sociable, they don't require as much maintenance or as much overseeing as other pets would, right? And they literally make money for you while you just don't have to do anything. There are so many ways to get involved without actually being there and watching the llama alpacas. You could do that, you don't have to do that, you don't have to sell anything. There are so many ways to do this. So again, I'm not telling you go retire, go get a farm and do this. I'm saying at least look into the option of possibly owning an alpaca and making some money. I'll help you at some point.
That's better, man. 845, 843. That's good.